Dobre. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما اللهم آتي أنفسنا تقواها وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها إن الله يرفع بهذا الكتاب أقواما ويدع به آخرين. This is the title or the subject inshallah we're going to speak about today. It comes from a hadith in which Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ أَيِّ الْقُرْآنِ أَقْوَامًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises with the Qur'an people, and He lowers with this same Qur'an others, meaning those who live by the Qur'an, act by the Qur'an, and dedicate themselves to the Qur'an, Allah raises them. And those that turn away from the Qur'an and give lie to it and pay it no mind, Allah will lower them. This hadith actually has a story behind it, in which the Emir of Mecca in the time of the Prophet, in the time of Umar, the Khilafah of Umar radiallahu anhu, the Emir of Mecca, which his name was Nafi' ibn Abd al-Harith. Nafi' ibn Abd al-Harith. He was the Emir of Mecca. And Umar, for some reason, he called him away from Mecca to a place called Usfan. So he was away from Mecca. He was away from his leadership there in Mecca. And he met Umar there. And Umar asked him, who did you leave back to lead the people of Mecca? Who did you leave back? And he said, I left a man called Ibn Abza. Ibn Abza. Umar, he asked him, he said, wa mabnu Abza. Who is Ibn Abza? Who is this individual? He said, Mawlan min Mawalina. He said, he is a slave from the slaves of Mecca. He is a slave from the slaves of Mecca. Yani, who did you leave in charge of the people of Mecca? He said, I left a man called Ibn Abza. Who is Ibn Abza? He said, a slave from the slaves of Mecca. For of course, Umar, the Khalifa, the leader, Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the believers, he said, you left over the people of Mecca, the people of Sharaf, the people of honor, the people of the Kaaba, Ashraf Buka' fil Ard, the most honorable place on the whole earth. You left in charge of them a slave? And then he said, yes. He said, إِنَّهُ قَارِئٌ لِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ عَالِمٌ بِالْفَرَائِدِ. He said he is a reciter, meaning he is a scholar of the Book of Allah. He knows the halal of the book. He knows the haram of it. And he is a scholar of fara'id, Islamic inheritance. Once Umar radiallahu anhu heard this statement that this slave was a person of knowledge and his relationship especially with the Book of Allah, Umar radiallahu anhu, he said easily, surely your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, إن الله يرفع بهذا الكتاب أقواما ويدع به آخرين. Your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, Allah surely raises with this book people and He lowers with this book others. There was nothing else he had to say. There was nothing else he had to say, because Umar radiallahu anhu, he understood the magnitude of this book. And the Sahaba, they understood the magnitude of this book. And what should be the miza? How should we differentiate between people? How should the believers differentiate between people? Who should have honor amongst us? Who should be raised up from amongst us? Who should be the people who are followed and looked after or looked up to? Who should be these people? Umar radiallahu anhu, once he heard that this person was a scholar of the Book of Allah, he said, okay, no problem. He has the right to lead over the people of Mecca. Because the Sahaba, they don't look at your color. They pass that. Inna akramukum inda Allahi atqaakum. They don't look at your wealth. Truly the most honorable of you or amongst you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most God-fearing, the most righteous, the most knowledgeable. يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ لِذِينَ آمَنُوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات. Allah raises those of iman from amongst you, and those who have been given knowledge, Allah raises them up even more. Now, another story that we get into. We know that people love stories, right? But these are beneficial stories. These are authentic stories. These are stories to يعني inspire us. Another story of Amr ibn Salim. He was a young boy from the tribe of Jurm. And he's about 7 years old when this story is taking place. And his tribe did not become Muslim yet. And he used to live by a bi'r, a well. And at this time, the people used to go to Muhammad. So this is when Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is in Medina. All the surrounding tribes did not become Muslim yet. His tribe did not become Muslim. The people used to go to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and they would ride back, and they would stop at this this tribe, and they would take from the bi'r, they would take from the well there. And him as a young boy, he will be there, he will help out, try to get some money, whatever the case may be. And they will be asking these people, these travelers, what did you hear from this Muhammad? What was he saying? And of course, what did Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to tell the people? The Quran. Huh? وَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مَنْ يَخَافُ الْوَعِيدِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and remind the people with the Quran. Huh? It wasn't too intricate. The da'wah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was not intricate. It was قَالَ اللَّهِ. Allah said this. This is what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told the people. So the people, they will come back and they will be asked at this well, what did this man say? Of course, they didn't believe in him yet. What did he used to say? And they will reply back with Quran. And this young boy, he would memorize that Quran that he heard just by hearing it. And this is an encouragement to those who have children who are young to try to push them to memorize the Quran in young age. Because it will be much, much easier for them to memorize the Quran in young age if they have enthusiasm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them the ability. They are like sponges. So I advise you and I encourage you, myself first and all of my brothers, to encourage and put our children in the maraqiz of tahfiz, the centers where the Quran is being memorized, and any place where the Quran is being memorized, and if you have to pay for it, pay for it. It's the best money you could spend. Now, so he said, I memorized that Quran from them. So then in the Fethi Mecca, the opening of Mecca, when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came back into Mecca and the Muslims became powerful, all these surrounding tribes, the majority of them, once they seen Muhammad was victorious, they became Muslim. Because they said, we're gonna wait. If he's truthful, Allah will give him victory. Huh? This is the understanding. If he's truthful, he's a truthful prophet, Allah will give him victory. So when they seen that he got the victory, they became Muslim. His tribe was one of them. So then his father goes to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he gives him bay'ah. He pledges to him and he says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa annaka rasulullah. And then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam begins to teach. He begins to teach him tawheed, la ilaha illallah, and the salah, and wudu, ablution, things like this, basics of the religion. And he tells him one important thing, and this is the point of our story. He says, when it's time for salah, let one of you call the adhan, and let the person who knows the most Quran lead you in salah. Who knew the most Quran from their tribe? Huh? Who knew the most Quran? Amr. And Amr is how old? 7 years old. And what did the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said? Let the person who knows what? The most Quran lead you in salah. And that is a qaida, a principle to this day. The person who is the most ahfad, ahfadukum bil Quran, the most memorized of you with the Quran, let him lead in salah. So his father goes back and he says, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this and said that. And he said, the one who knows the most Quran, let him lead us in salah. So they look around. And Amr is narrating this. He's narrating this hadith. So they look around and they see, and he said, I was the only one who knew Quran. So him as 7 years old, he leads his whole tribe in salah. Allahu Akbar. And he's a poor boy. And remember the point that we're talking about, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرُفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ. Allah raises with this book people, right? This is a boy 7 years old. He's leading his people in the most honorable thing, which is salah. He's leading the salah, and he's narrating this, and he says, that there was a woman behind him who, when he would bend down, he would make prostration, his backside would show. They're poor people. Not like today, we have a lot of clothes, mashallah. Then maybe some person maybe only has one kameez, one shirt. Or maybe he has one izar, he may only have one bottom piece in the time of the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and even today in some place around the earth. Now, so he said that when he would make prostration, his backside would show. And this woman said, غَطُّ عَنَّ إِسْتَقَائِكُمْ. She said, would you cover the backside of your reciter, of your imam, cover his backside? So then he said, and then my whole tribe came together and they raised money up for me and they bought me a whole new outfit. And he said, wallahi, it was the most afrah, it was the most joyful day of my whole life. When he's a little boy, subhanAllah. So, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابَ أَقْوَامًا وَيَضَعُ بِآخَرِينَ. Allah raises up with this book people and he lowers with this book people. Now, so there's nothing that comes in contact with the book of Allah except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise that thing up. And especially we're speaking now and we're getting ready for the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to see the month of Ramadan. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yumayyiz? What did he distinguish Ramadan with in the Quran? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, when he mentions Shahr Ramadan, there's only one time in the Quran. Allah says, Shahr Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. Shahr Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. Hudan lin-nasi wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan. Faman shahida minkum al-shahr falyasum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when speaking about Ramadan, and then getting ready to make or to tell us and to command us with fasting, what does he say? شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan in which the Quran was revealed in. The month of Ramadan in which the Quran was revealed in. So this is telling us that what raised Ramadan up? What made Ramadan the best of the months? This descending of the Quran. Now, this descending of the Quran made Ramadan the best of all the shuhur, على الإطلاق. The best of all the shuhur. What happens in Ramadan? Huh? What happens in Ramadan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens up all the gates of the paradise. وَلَمْ يُغْلَقْ مِنْهَا بَابٍ. And not even one door will be closed. وَيُغَلَّقْ أَبْوَابِ جَهَنَّمَ. And all the gates of the hellfire will be closed. وَلَمْ يُفْتَحْ مِنْهَا بَابٍ. And not even one door will be open. Huh? And Allah will chain up the shayateen. Huh? Chain of the shayateen wa maradat al-jinn, and the evil of the jinn, of the jinns. And muhim, we're speaking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised this month up. What did he mention in the Quran? He mentioned that shahr Ramadan الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. The month of Ramadan in which the Quran has been revealed. And in this month we have one night, Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. The Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. Surely we made it, we descended it down in لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. What did we descend down? Al-Qur'an. Al-Qur'an. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we surely sent down this Qur'an in the night of power. The night of power is better than 1,000 months. What did Allah mention before saying it's better than 1,000 months? He mentioned that he sent down the book of Allah. He sent down the Quran. This raised this night. So the best of all nights is Laylatul Qadr. Why? Because the Quran was sent down. The best of all months is Ramadan. Why? Because the Quran was sent down in that month. Now, now, and who did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose to descend with this Quran? Jibreel alayhi salam. Jibreel alayhi salam. And we know for sure, without a doubt, the best of the malaika, rather Sayyidul Malaika, the master of the angels. Rather, he is the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made him responsible for descending down the wahi, descending down revelation. Jibreel alayhi salam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنزِيلُ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ عَلَى قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنْ الْمُنْذِرِينَ بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍ مُبِينٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, and surely this is a revelation that came from the Lord of the worlds, meaning the Quran. And who came down with it? Jibreel alayhi salam. And what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call him? Ar-Ruh al-Amin, the trustworthy spirit. Ar-Ruh al-Amin. Ar-Ruh al-Amin.
And this is why he is the best of the malaika. And if we see and we study the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he speaks of the malaika and he speaks about Jibril, he puts Jibril in one kaf and he puts the malaika in another kaf. He says, Ar-Ruh wal Malaika. Ar-Ruh wal Malaika. The spirit meaning Jibril and al Malaika. Allah raised up Jibril alayhi salam because he made him the one who was responsible for the ascension of what? The wahy of this Quran. Raised him up because of this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُنذَرِينَ. Upon the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so you can be of the warners. What raised Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam up? What raised him up? When he was in Ghar Hira, when he was in the cave Hira, and Jibril came to him and came and said and hugged him tight and said, اقرأ اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ ربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. This raised up Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is why we love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is why he is the best of creation على الإطلاق, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he is the best of all of the Anbiya wa Rusul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when his Quran came down to him and mixed with him and made him al-Bashir wa Nadir. Huh? This Quran came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. And we have raised your remembrance. And now we're here in Queens, New York, 2021, and we're mentioning him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because this Quran, when that Quran came to him when he's in Ghar Hira, when he is in that cave, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trying to figure out what is his purpose here, that Quran came to him. And then that mission came to him, that risala came to him, and now we are here, we are still following that man. And we love him. And he is more important to us than our own lives. And we love him more than we even love our own selves, and that's true iman. And we name our children after him. And every time he's mentioned, we say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And every single day, every single part of the earth, we are saying ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Every single part of the earth. What happened? That Quran came to him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابَ أَقْوَامًا وَيَضَعُ بِآخَرِينَ. Allah raises up with this book people. He raises with his speech people. And he lowers with his speech others. He lowers others and he raises up others. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And نحن أمة محمد sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are the ummah of Muhammad. We are the ummah of Muhammad. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran in Surah Ali Imran, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَلَى الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. You are the best nation that has came out to the people. The Ummah of Muhammad. The Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are the best nation that has came out to the people. What makes us different from the previous nations? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he sent Muhammad al-Qur'an. And the more we will raise up as this, as an ummah, is the closest we get to this book. And the more we will be lowered, and the more we will be lowered, and the more we will be disgraced, and the more we will be humiliated when we go away from the Qur'an. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْفَعُ بِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ وَيَضَعُ بِهِ آخَرِينَ. Allah raises up with this book people and he lowers with this book others. The more we give ourselves to this book, the more we read this book and try to understand it and apply it in our lives and raise our households amongst it. It doesn't matter, you don't have to be in a place, even if the society is a kafir society. They're not worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't know Quran. You practice the Quran in your home and with your own self. And you make the sharia, the constitution of this book. You make it your constitution in your life and in your home. And you will see how Allah will raise you. And you will see how He will raise your family. In this life and the hereafter. In this life and the hereafter. Wallahi, I know nobody in my short time in this world. I know no one who dedicated themselves to the book of Allah except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala akramahum. Allah was generous and honored them. I know nobody. I know no one who dedicated themselves and read the Quran daily and contemplated over the ayat of the Quran. And listened to the Quran Huh? Except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala akramuhum. Huh? Raise them up amongst the people. Raise them up amongst their brothers in the family. Raise them up amongst the people in the community. Huh? Made them a person, alimi. Made them a person who was worldwide person. Take them up, raise them all the way up with this book. Wallahi tallahi wa billahi. Even in the dunya as well. Even dunya wise. Even money. Huh? We know we love money. وَإِنُّهُ لِيُحِبُّ الْخَيْرِ لَا شَدِيدٍ. Everyone loves money, right? Even in a worldly aspect. Someone who gave himself to the book of Allah, you think that you're going to lose out? Maybe our children think that they will lose out. If somebody goes and dedicates some years to memorizing Quran and to learn it. You see everybody going to college and maybe getting cars or something like this or studying. They think, I may be going to lose out on my dunya. Wallahi tallahi wa billahi, you're wrong. Wallahi tallahi wa billahi, you're wrong. You think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to humiliate you if you dedicate yourself to His book? Allah is going to raise you. He's going to aid you. He's going to send people in your direction. He's going to make what took them 5 years is going to take you 6 months. what they had to do to achieve it in 5, 6, 7, 8 years, you're going to achieve it in a year. That's the barakah. That's the barakah of the book of Allah. Wallahi, I'm telling you, I know no one. And you should encourage you. I encourage myself, I encourage my brothers in the deen. And I wish it was more young people here. I would encourage them, do not look twice. Do not think twice. You have the opportunity to give time to the book of Allah and to learn it and to memorize it and to study it and know the meanings of it. Wallahi, this is a path of all goodness in the dunya wal akhirah. This is a door to all goodness in dunya wal akhirah. For the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أَهْلِينَ مِنَ النَّاسِ إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أَهْلِينَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. This is the second part of the lecture that I want to get into. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أَهْلِينَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. قَالُوا مَنْ هُمْ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Who are these people, O Messenger of Allah? قَالُوا هُمْ أَهْلُ الْقُرْآنِ أَهْلُ اللَّهِ وَخَاسَتُهُ. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has special chosen people. Special chosen people. The Sahaba, when they hear this, they say, Ya Rasulullah, who are these people? They're yearning, they want to be of them. They want to be of these people that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is talking about. Who are these special chosen people, Ya Rasulullah? He said, Hum Ahlul Quran. These special chosen people. These close people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, awliya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, friends of Allah, people that when they put their hands up, Allah answers. People that if someone tries to harm them, Allah defends them. Now, people when they're in need, Allah gives them. Who are they, O Messenger of Allah? He said, Hum Ahlul Quran. They are the people of Quran. Wallahi, tallahi wa billahi. I swear by Allah. I swear by Allah. Yani, we Muslims, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a long time, but 95% of us don't know the reality of what I'm speaking about. 98% of us don't know the reality of what I'm speaking about. It's only that 2% or that 1% of the people who really dedicated themselves to the book of Allah could even understand what I'm talking about. The rest of the people don't know what I'm talking about at all. And that's why I understand. Only a small percentage of the people who stayed up in the nights reading the book of Allah and memorizing it and making tahajjud and praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and crying when the ayat touched their heart and going over the ayat day in and day out and day in and day out and day in and day out, reviewing the book of Allah over and over again and applying the book of Allah in their life. It's only a few people who know what I'm talking about. Majority of the people don't know what I'm saying. These are the special chosen people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Special chosen people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahlul Quran, the people of the Quran. Does not go 5 minutes unless an ayah is coming in their head. They don't have idle time. These people, there's no idle time. There's no surfing the web, going on YouTube, playing around. When they have free time, they open up the book of Allah. Rather, forget free time. Even in the time they're busy, they make time for the Quran. It's the most beautiful thing to them. It's the most beloved thing to them. The book of Allah. They read the book of Allah day in and day out. When they wake up in the night, when they wake up from sleep, they read the Quran. They ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, don't take this Quran from me. They dedicate their time when the people are out running and chasing the dunya and they give it to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's only a few people who know this. It's only a few people who went through this path. They had to sacrifice for this. They had to sacrifice their money. They had to sacrifice their time. They had to sacrifice helping their families. They had to sacrifice their education for the book of Allah. But wallahi, Allah will never disgrace them. Allah will never disgrace them. Allah promises that. He will never disgrace these people. Rather, He will honor them, and He will increase them, and He will raise them up, and He will take care of them, and He will barakah in their lives, and put barakah in their wealth, and put barakah in their children, and put barakah in their amal, in their work. That's the reality. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أَهْلِينَ مِنَ النَّاسِ Allah has special chosen people. Who are they, Ya Messenger of Allah? Whom أَهْلُ الْقُرْآنِ They are the people of the Qur'an. أَهْلُ اللَّهِ أهل الله, the people of Allah, وخاصته, his special, chosen, close people of the Quran. Now, we are here, and we have this time coming to us, the month of Ramadan, and we want to just give a few points, that if we acted upon these points, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, we can try to become from amongst these people. And I don't want to sell us something because it's going to take work and it's going to take dedication. But I want to give us a few points and maybe we can apply it, especially in this Shahrul Mubarak, this blessed month coming that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy when the Malik will come out and will say, Ya Baghi al-Khair Akbil, Ya Baghi al-Khair Akbil, Oh, the one who is desirous to do good, come near in this month. Ya Baghi al-Khair Aqbil, the one who wants to do good, the one who wants to pray, the one who wants to make siyam, the one who wants to pray in the night, the one who wants to give charity, come near, this is your month, this is your time. Maybe inshallah, with this changed atmosphere, maybe we'll be able to do some goodness and change our lives and come closer to the book of Allah in this month. Wallahi, inshallah, we ask Allah to give us barakah and to bless us inshallah in this month to get closer to His word. Because if we get closer to His word, wallahi, we get closer to Him. And if we get closer to Him, our communities rise. Now, because the tawfiq, the success, the nasr, and the aid is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Alone. First aspect. We try to increase in reading, inshallah, reading the book of Allah, al-qira'ah, reading the book of Allah every single day. Make a portion of your day that you are going to read. Take the Facebook off, take the WhatsApp, take the YouTube, read the book of Allah. And you will get ajr, reward. A lot of reward for it. Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله به حسنة. Whoever reads one letter from the book of Allah, he will get a good deed for it. One letter. Huh? والحسنة بعشر أمثالها. And the letter will be multiplied by 10. So every letter you read in the book of Allah, huh? It will be multiplied by 10. Then the Prophet of Allah said, he said, لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف. I'm not saying that ألف لام and ميم is a حرف. It's not a letter. لكن ألف is a حرف. Is a letter. ولام حرف. وميم حرف. That's what? 30 حسنات and 3 letters. 30 good deeds for reading 3 letters of the book of Allah. Read. وفي الآخرة and in the hereafter, what will happen? Prophet of Allah he said, اقرأوا هذا الكتاب فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفاعا شفاعا لصاحبه. Read this book because it will come يوم القيامة as an intercessor for you. This book will come to you يوم القيامة when you're in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are naked and afraid. You are naked and uncircumcised and you're afraid. That time you spent with the book of Allah, it will come. And it will say, Ya Allah, forgive him, Ya Rabbi. Ya Rabbi. The Quran, imagine, it will come, Ya Rabbi, forgive him. Ya Rabbi, pardon him, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Pardon him. The Quran, Ya Rabbi, enter him in the paradise, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, don't put him in the hellfire, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Huh? اقرأوا هذا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفاعا لأصحابه. Read the book of Allah because it will come يوم القيامة as an intercessor for you, as the one who is close to it. Now, so al-qira'ah, let's try to read the book of Allah every single day. We try to read as much as we can and reflect as well. Secondly, at-tilawah. Let's try to nuhsin tilawatana. Let's try to make better our recitation. Let's try to make it better. No one should feel that's for the young guys. I'm done. No. Everybody, young, old, man, woman. Because this is the speech of your Creator. This is the speech of your Creator. And we should feel ashamed, and I'm not putting anybody down, but I'm saying if we're not trying, we should feel ashamed if we don't know how to read it correctly. Meaning we don't know the idgham, we don't know the rules of nun sakina with tanween, we don't know the tajweed rules at all. I'm not saying that, yani, if you don't know it, this means you're a bad person. I'm saying if you're not trying to know it, this is where the blame is. It's not if you don't know it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to judge you for something you didn't know or was difficult for you. What we get judged for is not trying. Okay? So alhamdulillah, Allah has blessed us with people of knowledge, blessed us with people who know tajweed, blessed us with people who give us time. Try to sit with somebody. Try to sit with them, at least so we can learn the Fatiha the correct way. At least we can learn the small surah, at least we can learn to read those the correct way. Because this, in fact, is a means to show our iman. Our iman is shown for reading the book of Allah the correct way. Where's my dalil? Do I have proof for that? Somebody saying, what's his dalil? I have dalil from Quran. Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابِ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. Those who we've given the book, we've given the Quran, they recite it in its correct, in its correct recitation. Those people believe in it. Those people what? Allah, Rabbul Alameen, He says, those who recite the book in the correct manner, those people believe in the book. They believe in it. So a sign of our iman is that we recite this book in the correct manner. Everyone is upon different levels. Some people is going to reach a level to be a qari, they're going to be a reciter. They're going to stand here in front of the people, they're going to leave their salawat. We're not saying everybody needs to be like him. But we're saying that we should be striving to at least learn the basics of how to recite the book of the one who created me and you. Huh? Now. And the Prophet of Allah, he gave us the bushra for those who is difficult for. He gave us the good news. He said, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنَ وَهُوَ مَاهِرٌ بِهِ مع السفرة الكرام البرة والذي يقرأ القرآن ويتتعتع فيه وهو عليه شاق فله أجران. Prophet of Allah said, he said, the one who reads the Quran in the correct way and he is good, he knows the tajweed, he knows the makharij, he knows how to recite the letters, he knows the ta min ta, he knows the da min da, he knows the difference between these letters. He knows the tajweed. He said he is with the malaika. That person, when he recites the Quran, the malaika are with this person. That's one person. He said, but the person who recites the Quran, وَيَتَتَعْتَعُ فِيهِ, he has difficulty with it. He stutters. He makes mistakes. It's hard for him. His tongue is not moving the correct way. He doesn't pronounce the letters the correct way. What the Prophet ﷺ say? He has two rewards. He has two rewards. So we have an excuse? We have no excuse. The one who's good at it, mashallah, huwa ma'al malaika, he's with the angels. But the person who is difficult for, he has two rewards. So we all need to strive at that. So we said first, inshallah, so we can try to be from the people of Quran. Firstly, the reading of the Quran. Second, the recitation of the Quran. Thirdly, memorizing of the Quran. This is something from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has distinguished this Ummah from all the other Ummah. We memorize our book. So when these people come and say, SubhanAllah, those people are dedicated. They know their book from front to back. I was giving da'wah to some people, huh? And it was a Christian man, and I was telling him, because he feels like he knows his book, every time he wants to give a verse from the Bible, he pulls out his phone. Right? And he said, so-and-so said this and so-and-so said that. And when I would say a verse from the Quran, I would say it from my head in Arabic and I translate it for him. And I say, yes, that's what we do. We memorize our book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has blessed us with that. We memorize our book. I don't need to open my phone to say what my Lord has said. Rather, that is in what? Our hearts. This Quran is supposed to be in our hearts, as Allah said in Surah Al-Ankabut, بَلْ هِيَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ فِي صُدُورِ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ وَمَا يَجْحَدُ بِآيَاتِنَا إِلَّا الظَّالِمُونَ. He said, rather, they are clear ayat, they are clear verses in the hearts of those people who've been given knowledge. Allah says that. Rather, they are clear ayat, they are clear verses in the hearts of the people who've been given knowledge. Now, Allah has preserved His book in the hearts of the Ummah, in the hearts of the Rijal, in the hearts of the people of knowledge, preserved His book. From the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until this time, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Surely, definitely, we have sent down this dhikr, this Qur'an, and surely we will preserve it. How has Allah preserved this book? He has preserved it in the hearts of mankind. He has preserved it in the hearts of the believers. So all of us, we want a piece of that. We want a piece of that. We want to come Yawm al-Qiyamah, and we want to be of those people who have said to them, يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ اِقْرَى وَارْتَقِي وَرَتِّلْ كَمَا كُنْتَ تُرَتُّلْ فِي الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ إِنْ دَآخِرَ آيَةٍ تَقْرَوْهَا. We want to be from those people, يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, that we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it said to us, read and recite and elevate. Read and recite and elevate in the paradise. Read and recite and elevate in the paradise, for surely your place in the paradise will be the last ayah that you recite. So we want to be from those people, inshallah. This comes from memorization. This comes from holding the book of Allah in our hearts. This is what it comes from, that sharaf azeem, that great honor yawm al-qiyamah, when you be reading the ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you be elevating in His paradise. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. This is the truth. We want to be from those people. Even the brothers who are older in age, you can even do the smaller surah. You can do it. One ayah a day. You can do it. You can do it. And it will sharpen you up too. It will keep you sharp. Memorize some Quran. Even an ayah, one ayah, two ayah, three. By the end of the week, you have seven ayah. Review that, review that, review, review, then move on. You see, you can memorize. Wallahi, we have 80-year-old women who memorize the Quran. 75-year-old women who memorize the Quran. Wallahi. You can go on YouTube, you see it. 80-year-old women memorize the Quran. The Sahaba, they think, you think they were all young? You had old, from them that was older, they memorized as well. So all of us need to have a part of this, inshallah. We're not saying everybody is going to be a hafiz. What we're saying is you must try. Don't stop. Don't take those first few years that you had that hamas, you had that energy, you had that zeal, and you memorized a few ayahs of Quran, a few surah, and you kept that for the rest of your Islam until you meet Allah. No. Huh? Start small, one ayah, two ayah, three ayah, four ayah, and this Ramadan. Try it out. Try it out. Then go to the sheikh, read for the sheikh. Read for the sheikh. He'll be pleased. He'll be pleased to see an elder man is coming and he's trying to still memorize. Subhanallah. That will give him iman. That will raise him in iman. Even the sheikh, he will say, Subhanallah, this brother, may Allah bless him. Nah. And Allah will see you doing that. And Allah may for that, He will make you, maybe make your son a hafiz. Maybe make your daughter a hafizah. Because He see you striving with the book of Allah. And your children, when they see you striving, that's the biggest da'wah. That's the biggest da'wah. When they see you working hard, they see you with the book of Allah all the time. When they see that, then it's much more easier for them to work hard with it. My father's doing it, my mother's doing it. Alhamdulillah, that's all we know. We people of the Quran. That's number three. We said reading, we said tilawa, reciting. Number three, memorization. We should try in the month of Ramadan. Try, inshallah. Work hard, bidhillahi ta'ala. Number four, at-tadabbur, reflecting over the ayat. This is of the most important aspects. Because this aspect, it puts yaqeen, it puts certainty in your heart. When you reflect over the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it puts yaqeen in your heart. It puts certainty in your heart. And when that certainty comes in your heart, then what comes after it is work. It comes amal, and it becomes easy. It becomes easy. Once the certainty comes in your heart that this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now everything in it is easy to follow now. It's easy to apply it. It's easy to stay away from what He said to stay away from. Because you believe that it's coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says is the purpose for the descending of the Quran. In Surah Sa'd, He said, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إليك كتاب أنزلناه مبارك إليك ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب أو كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى. He said it is a blessed book that we have sent down that they may reflect over its ayat. It is a blessed book that we sent down that they may reflect and ponder over the ayat. We should not just be reading, and this is intabihu, we should not just be reading to finish the book. We mentioned reading the Quran, but we should not be just be reading just to finish the Quran. Some people said, I finished the Quran 3 times in Ramadan. Okay, how much did you reflect over? How much did you understand? If you finished the Quran and you have nothing in your head, you didn't benefit. If you read the whole Quran and you have nothing in your head, nothing that you remember, nothing that moved you, nothing that you grew in knowledge with, then what did you get barakah, you get blessings for reading, alhamdulillah, your niyyah is correct, but did you really benefit from the purpose of the Quran, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, liyadabbaru ayati, so they may reflect over the ayat. So if you was to take, instead of reading a juz in the day, you read one page and you reflected over it, wallahi, that one page is better for you than the whole juz. Wallahi, it's better for you. If you took one ayah, and you reflected over it, it's better for you than reading the whole Quran without reflection. And I'm confident in that statement. I'm confident. Huh? Because we are supposed to reflect over this ayah, like I said, and the reflection, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ عَلَى الْقُرْآنِ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدَ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اِخْتِلَافٍ كَثِيرًا. Allah said, do they not contemplate over the Quran? If it was from other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will find in it many, contradictions. Huh? اِخْتِلَافٍ كَثِيرًا. They'll find many contradictions in it. Do they not contemplate? So Allah is saying, if they did contemplate on it, they will know that this Quran is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because there's no contradictions in it. Huh? You understand this point right here? If they did reflect over the Quran, then that reflection will lead them to realize and understand and acknowledge that this Quran is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, there's no contradiction in it and we must follow it and we must apply it in our lives. So the reflection leads to certainty and certainty leads to action. And the Quran has been sent down for that matter. The Quran has been sent down for that matter. Na'am. And that leads me to my last and final point, which is applying the Quran. Applying the Quran in our lives. Applying the Quran in our lives. We don't have time, brothers. We don't have no time. Wallahi, everyone can look around here to your brothers here, mashallah, beautiful faces, shining faces. Maybe someone in here does not make it through Ramadan. Maybe someone in here does not make it to see the Eid. Maybe someone would die. That's a high possibility. Every single year someone dies in Ramadan. In every community, someone dies in Ramadan. Every community. It could be someone here, it could be me, it could be you. This is the year that we need to increase. We need to go harder. This is the year that we do more. We do more ta'ah. We do more obedience. We stay away from the prohibitions. We do more. That haram that we've been doing, that little small haram that we've been doing, that we think that we can meet Allah with that haram, we're going to leave that inshallah in this month. Because that piles up and it piles up and it piles up like firewood. That small sin that we keep doing over and over again. We think it's small. It's piling up like firewood and it's going to burn you. As the Prophet of Allah said, he made that same example about small deeds. Small misdeeds. Keep looking at your phone, looking at that haram over and over and over again. Keep backbiting over and over and over and over again. Huh? Keep lying over and over and over again. Whatever the case may be, whatever your sin may be, it's time for us to leave that. And it's time for us to apply the Quran in our lives, in every aspect of it. If we're not raising our families upon this Quran, today we need to start. We're not raising our children upon this Quran and raising our household upon this Quran. Today is the day we need to start. This Ramadan is the time we need to start because this is the purpose for it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell us that I gave you my book. I gave you my guidance. I gave you my guidance. We have no excuse the day of judgment. Allah has given His book and He has made it clear. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه لا ريب فيه. That is the book that has no unclarity to it. There's nothing unclear about it. It's very certain and واضح. Clear book. We have no excuses. This is the time to practice. This time to apply the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not in front of the people. Not in front of the people. You know that in front of the people stuff that means nothing when you by yourself. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. Those who fear their Lord in the unseen, they will have forgiveness and a great, great reward. So this Quran, as the Prophet of Allah said, القرآن حجة لك أو عليك. The Quran will be a proof for you the day of judgment, or will be a proof against you. We want it to be a proof for us. We want that day that Quran will say, whatever was halal, he made it halal. Whatever was haram, he made it haram in his life. This is what we want that day of judgment. Because this is the reality, wallahi brothers. Wallahi, this is the reality. Wallahi, this dunya is faniya. This dunya is nothing. This dunya is a few days. Wallahi, means nothing. Fighting and bickering and playing around and following our desires. Everyone, I'm speaking about myself first. Running around, forgetting about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Being lazy with our ibadah. Being lazy, not giving ourselves to the deen, not sacrificing for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worrying about ourselves, not worrying about our brothers and sisters who are in need. Worrying about our own, not actualizing the day of judgment. Wallahi, brothers, this is the time to step up and tie our boots and tie our belts and work hard in the month of Ramadan. Last year, we weren't able to come in the house of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took that away from us last year. That's something we need to contemplate about. Maybe it was from our own sins. Maybe because we didn't appreciate the house of Allah. Maybe. But now, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is opening the door again for you. Open the door again for me. Open the door again for us. Don't mess it up. It's time for us to come and get serious. Give ourselves to the book of Allah and apply it in our lives and our families and try to grow and actualize the akhirah. Actualize standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actualize that. And let that actualization show on our speech and show on our actions. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us, inshallah, of the people of the Quran. Bidillahi ta'ala, make our children from the people of the Quran. Allahumma ameen. And anything that was wrong from me, that is from myself, from the shaitan. And anything that is correct is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Wa ma tawfiqi illa billah. And I have no success except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I want to thank all the brothers here in this masjid and this community and the management and all the brothers who were a means of putting this together. And I want to make dua for this masjid and for this community to prosper inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them in this blessed month of Ramadan and for the whole year going forward, and for all the other speakers who are going to speak, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah in their speech and benefit those who are listening. Allahumma ameen. Subhanallah wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.